Welcome to Power BI tutorial. In this tutorial, we will perform exploratory data analysis, EDA, on Netflix Userbase Dataset. EDA is used to summarize and analyze a data set using visualizations. Let's get started. The data set contains user ID, subscription type, monthly revenue, joining date, last payment date, country, age, gender, device, and plan duration. As usual, we will use the Get Data feature to import data from CSV file. Wait for the data to connect. Now you can load the data by pressing the Load button. Once the load button is pressed, the data will be loaded into the Power BI desktop, and all the fields will be available for visualization. Now we can start our analysis. We will start by adding title to our dashboard, using a text box visual. In our first analysis, we will count the number of record in all the main fields. We will add a column chart to our dashboard, and add all the main fields to the y-axis of the column chart, as count. Next, we will create a duplicate of the same chart. We will use this chart to display number of distinct items in each field. We will simply change the count function to count distinct function in each field on y-axis of the column chart. We now have the number of distinct items in each field. In our next analysis, we will display the numeric fields only as average. We will remove all the other fields. We will keep the age field, and add the monthly revenue field as average, both of whom are the numeric fields. In the next chart, we will display the minimum values in all numeric fields. We will simply change the function from average to minimum. Similarly, we can also display the maximum values in our numeric fields. We will simply change the function in y-axis to maximum. Using the same technique, we will also display the standard deviation, variance, and median. In our next dashboard, we will perform exploratory analysis on the main fields or columns in our data set. For our next visual, we will import a histogram, using the import visual feature. Once imported successfully, we will add the visual to our dashboard. We will then add the age field to the values area of the histogram visual. We will add the age field to the frequency area of the histogram as well, but as count. Let's change the title of the frequency field to number of customers. We can also change the bin size. As you can see, currently the bin are in decimal. Let's change the bin size to 5 and see the result. We should also remove decimals from ages and numbers. Now, the histogram looks much better. Now we will display number of customers by country. Change the map visual to column chart visual. We will add the country field to the y-axis of column chart as count and rename it to number of customers. In the next visual, we will display the number of customers by devices, by adding the device field to the values area of a pie chart as count, and renaming it to number of customers. We will display number of customers by gender, by adding gender field to the values area of a pie chart as count, and renaming it as number of customers. For our next visual, we will convert the join date from text to a proper date, using the date DAX function. We will create a new column named join date proper. We will use the date function to create proper date format. We will take year from the last two digits of the join date column. We will add 2000 to these two digits to make a correct four-digit year. Middle two digits will be used as month from the join date column. The first two digits will be used as days. And now we have proper, machine-readable dates. Next, we will calculate days using the date column. We will create a new column named join date days. There is a function named date difference, which we will use to calculate number of days. Date 1 will be the today date. Date 2 will be the recently created join date proper. We will use the day parameter, as we want the result in days. We will use this join date days field to create a histogram. We will add the join date days field to the values area. The same field will be added to the frequency area as count, renamed as number of customers. We will set the bin size to 5. We will also remove the decimal points from the visual. The number of customers by join date is ready. Next, we will convert the last payment date field from text to a proper date using the date function in DAX. For this, we will modify the existing formula that we created previously. Similarly, Using the previously created formula to calculate the number of days, we will calculate the number of days for the last payment date. Now, we will use the number of days of last payment date to create a histogram visual. We will add the last payment date days field to the values area, and the same to the frequency area as count. We will rename the frequency field to number of customers. Let's change the bin size to 5 and remove decimals from both x and y axis of the histogram. To analyze the monthly revenue, let's drag the field to our dashboard and change the visual to a histogram, then add the monthly revenue field as count and rename it to number of customers. You can change the bin size from the format area and also set the decimal points of x and y axis here. We will add the plan duration to our dashboard, and since there is only one plane, we will place it at the top of the dashboard as a text visual. Finally, we will add a pie chart to display number of customers by subscription type. By adding subscription type to values area as count and renaming it as number of customers, we will add a new page to display number of customers by country. Adding the country field to the dashboard will automatically create a map visual. We can change its style from the format window. Let's add country field another time and change the map visual to a pie chart. We will add the country field to the values area as count and rename it to number of customers. We will do the same to the map visual as well. But here, we will add the field to the bubble size area. Our country analysis is complete. We will add a new page to display devices by country. To analyze devices by country, we will add a column chart to our dashboard. The user ID or another field must be added to the y-axis as count. We will call it customers. The device field will be added to the legend area. Finally, we will add the country field to the small multiples area to display devices by country. We can change the number of rows and columns for better visualization. We will set 2 rows and 5 columns for our visual. To display gender by country, we will create a duplicate of existing dashboard. Just rename the title to gender by country. In the legend area, replace the device field with the gender field. And this is it. Similarly, we will create another dashboard by duplicating the existing one to show subscription type by country. We will just rename the title of the dashboard. And in the legend area, we will replace the gender field with the subscription type field. Finally, we will perform some gender analysis. We will again create a duplicate from existing dashboard and rename its title. Here we will analysis devices and subscription type by gender. To analyze subscription type by gender, we will replace the small multiples field with the gender field. Now we will just set the number of columns to 2 and the number of rows to 1. To display devices by gender, we will duplicate the existing visual and replace the subscription type field in legend area with the devices field. Our exploratory data analysis is now complete. There are far more analysis you can do, and many visuals you can add your EDA. The links to the histogram, data set, and the Power BI file are placed in the description below. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.